Hello there. My name is Utkarsh Mittal, and I'm a Senior Product Manager at AWS. In this demo, I will walk you through how you can get started with Amazon DataZone. So let's see what all we will cover in this demo. We will first talk a little bit about what Amazon DataZone is and what are the key components of Amazon DataZone. Then we will explain a simple end-to-end customer workflow that covers the core functionalities of DataZone. And finally, we will go through step-by-step process of how you can implement this workflow on DataZone. So let's get started. Amazon DataZone is a new service that allows you to catalog, discover, share, govern, and analyze data across organizational boundaries. In any organization, you have data producers, such as data engineers and data scientists, who produce data. On the other side, you have data consumers, such as analysts and line of business users, who consume that data to build analyses, dashboards, or get valuable business insights from that data. Amazon DataZone bridges the gap between the data producers and data consumers. With DataZone, data producers can easily catalog and share the data that they produce, and data consumers can easily find, access, and analyze that data using the right analytics tools. And it comes with the right governance mechanisms built in. Amazon DataZone introduces several new concepts. So before we jump into the actual demo of the product, let's understand some of the core components of DataZone. The first component is a domain. A DataZone domain represents the distinct boundary of a line of business or a business area within an organization that can manage its own data, including its own data assets, its own definition of data or business terminology, and may have its own governing standards. Domain is the starting point of a customer's journey with DataZone. When you first start using DataZone, you start by creating a domain, and all the core components then exist within the domain. The second core component is a business data catalog, where you can catalog the data across the organization with business metadata. The business data catalog enables you to make the data visible with business context, so that anyone in the organization can find and understand that data quickly. The third component is projects and environments. Project is a new construct that enables you to create business use case-based groupings of people, data, and analytics tools. Projects provides users a space where members of the project are able to collaborate on a specific business use case. Within projects, you can create environments which provide the necessary infrastructure to project members, such as analytics tools, storage, and the necessary permissions so that project members can easily produce new data or consume data that they already have access to. The fourth component is governance and access control, which is enabled by the publish and subscribe workflows in DataZone. The publish workflow enables data producers to easily publish their data to the DataZone catalog. And the subscribe workflow enables data consumers to subscribe to or access the data that has been published to the catalog. DataZone has built-in workflows that allow owners of the data to review the subscription requests. And once they approve a request, DataZone can automatically grant the access by managing permissions at the underlying data store, such as AWS LakeFormation and Amazon Redshift. The fifth component is the data portal. The data portal is a web-based application where DataZone users can experience all of the capabilities of DataZone that we just talked about. It's an out-of-AWS console application that can be accessed through your organization's corporate single sign-on. And finally, APIs. DataZone has public APIs available that will allow you to interact with DataZone programmatically. So now that we have some idea about the core components of DataZone, let's explore the sample workflow we will implement on DataZone. We will implement a simple end-to-end workflow where marketing team is looking to access and analyze sales data. Marketing team is the data consumer in this scenario, and sales team will make this data available for marketing by publishing an AWS Glue table called Catalog Sales to the business data catalog. Now, to keep things simple, we will limit this implementation to a single AWS account, a single region, and a single IAM user who will act as both the data producer and the data consumer, and we will work with a single data asset. In the next few videos of this demo series, we will build on this use case by introducing more advanced use cases, such as how to enable single sign-on, or how to publish and subscribe to data across multiple accounts. So here are the different steps that we will go through. We will first set up DataZone. Then we will look at the publishing flow, where as sales team, we will create a producer project, create an environment within the project, produce some sales data, and publish it to the business data catalog. Then we will look at the subscription flow, where as marketing team, we will create a consumer project, create an environment within the project, subscribe to the sales data that was published by the sales team, and query that data in Athena. So let's build this use case on DataZone. The first step to enabling DataZone for your organization is to create a DataZone domain. Now, this step is done in the AWS Management Console. You can simply search for DataZone in the AWS Management Console and go to the service homepage. Now, before you start creating the domain, make sure that you have necessary permissions to create it. You can find the required permissions on DataZone's documentation page. So let's create the domain now. On the DataZone homepage, click on Create Domain button. Provide a name for the domain. For service access, we will pick the first option where DataZone will automatically create a new role called Amazon DataZone Domain Execution Role. Now, this role will include necessary permissions that authorize DataZone to make API calls on behalf of users within the domain. Next, we will pick the Quick Setup option where DataZone can take care of all the necessary steps to set up DataZone. So let's create the domain. Behind the scenes, DataZone creates necessary IAM roles and enables this domain to use resources within your account, such as AWS Glue Data Catalog, Amazon Redshift, and Amazon Athena. Now, once the domain is available, you will see that it generates a URL to the data portal. You can click on this URL and jump into the data portal. Once in the data portal, you will notice that it's currently a blank slate. In the top navigation bar, you can see that the business data catalog is currently empty. So let's publish a data asset to the catalog. To do this, we will first need to create a project. For this, we will select the Create option, provide a name for the project, provide a description, and that's it. Let's create the project. Once we have the project, we will need to work with data and analytics tools in the project. For this, we will create an environment. So let's go to the Environment tab and click on Create Environment. We will provide a name for the environment, provide a description. Next, we will pick an environment profile. An environment profile is a predefined template that includes technical details required to create an environment, such as which AWS account and region should the environment be created in, what resources and tools should be added to this environment. Here you can see that DataZone automatically creates a couple of default environment profiles for simplification. We will pick the Data Lake environment profile, which enables you to publish data from your Amazon Simple Storage Service and AWS Glue-based data lakes, and it also simplifies querying AWS Glue tables that you have access to using Amazon Athena. Next, we will click on this Create Environment button. It will take about a minute for this environment to get created because in the background, DataZone is creating certain resources in your AWS account. For example, an IAM role, which enables a project to act as an identity principle. Any access to data is granted to this identity principle instead of relying on individual user identity. The environment also creates an Amazon S3 suffix, AWS Glue databases, and an Athena workgroup, which simplify it for the members of the project to produce and consume data in the data lake. Now that we have the environment, next thing we need is an AWS Glue table that we can publish. We will create this table in Amazon Athena. To go to Athena, you can click on this Athena link on the right-hand side of the environment page. Now, if you're familiar with Athena, you will notice that instead of your workgroup, it's your environment that shows up here. Now, in the database dropdown, you will see that there are two databases that environment has access to. First, there is a PubDB or a publishing database. The purpose of this PubDB is to provide you a space where you can produce new data and choose to publish it to the DataZone catalog. The other database is SubDB or subscription database. As a project member, when you subscribe to some data in the catalog, the data is shared with you in the SubDB of the environment within the project. Now we will use a simple SQL query to create a table. For this, you can refer to DataZone's user guide, where you can copy the SQL query under the Getting Started section. We will paste this query in Athena, and this will create a table called Catalog Sale in Environment's publishing database. We can now go back to the DataZone portal and publish this table to the DataZone catalog. Now, to publish this table, we need a data source. With an environment, DataZone automatically creates a data source for us. And if you open this data source, you will see that this is configured to access tables in Environment's publishing database, where we had just created the catalog sales table. Now, the star here indicates that data source will bring in all the tables it finds in the PubDB into DataZone. Let's look at some other details as well. We can see that automated metadata generation is enabled for this data source, which means that any asset that data source brings into DataZone, DataZone will automatically generate business names of tables and columns for that asset. So let's run this data source. Once the data source has finished running, you can see that it brought in catalog sales table. We can open this asset and see that publishing job was able to automatically extract the technical metadata, including the schema of the table and several other technical details such as AWS account, region, and the physical location of the data. But it does not stop at just the technical metadata. You see these icons here? This indicates that DataZone also generated business names. You can simply accept these recommendations if they look correct instead of providing these manually. On the schema tab also, you can see that it generates the business names for each column. Now these business names look correct to me, so I'll just simply accept all the recommendations. That was quite convenient, right? So now that we have added some business metadata, let's publish this asset to the catalog using the publish button here. Once the asset has been published, it becomes discoverable in the catalog. So let's test it by typing sales in the search bar, and we can see that catalog sales table starts showing up in the search results. Great, so now that we understand how the publishing flow works, now let's switch into the shoes of the marketing team and see how we can subscribe to or request access to this table. Now to subscribe, we need a new project. Let's create a project called Marketing Consumer Project. We will also create a data lake environment in this project using the same steps as before. Now once the environment has been created, let's go and open the catalog sales table in the catalog and click on subscribe button. We will pick the marketing consumer project, provide a reason for access, and submit the request. Now this alerts the publisher of the data about subscription request. Now since we are acting as both subscriber and publisher here, we will see a notification. You can click on this notification, which will open the subscription request, where we can see the details, including which project has requested access, who is the requester, and why do they need access. Now to approve, we can simply click on the approve button and provide a reason for approval. Now that subscription has been approved, let's go back to the consumer project and see what we see there. Under subscribe data, we can see that catalog sales table starts showing up as an approved asset, but the access has not been granted yet. We can see that DataZone is working on necessary backend plumbing to automatically grant the access. Now, once that is done, we can see that this asset has been added to the environment. Now that Marketing Consumer Project has access to the sales data, let's see how we can use Athena to analyze this. Let's go to the Marketing Consumer Project and click on the Athena link, which will take you to Athena. We can see that the catalog sales table is showing up under the subscription database. To make sure that we have access to this table, we can preview it, and we can see that the query executes successfully. So in this demo, we saw how DataZone simplifies it for the publishers to share the data and for consumers to find, access, and analyze that data. That is all we have for this demo. Thank you for watching.